Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Claudia Albers, Planet X Research and Professional Physicist. And today I'd like to talk to you about another one of my articles. And this one is entitled, The Brown Dwarf Star Causing the Sun to Lose Light Emission and Jolt. Now, on August 10th of 2007, a bright object appears in the Core 2B images, and these are shown in Figure 1. And the object, we are led to believe, is Venus, but as we will see, it cannot be Venus because the Sun has a strong reaction to it. And it could not possibly have had such a strong reaction to a planet. And so this is from Stereo B. They are from 10 years ago, but I think they show effects and responses from the Sun that are very interesting and applicable to what is happening nowadays. Now, we see that the object appears here, and as it gets closer to the Sun, it becomes dimmer. We also see a region of light emission here, indicating that there is a source of light here. So the Sun is not the only source of light. There is another object that is a source of light, and of course, that would be a stellar object. Now, here we see where Stereo B is. As you can see, Venus is here, so it could be that it was seeing Venus. Notice that Earth is quite close to Venus's position as well. Now, this is a close-up of the object, and we see a particle flux transfer here. And why I think it's a particle flux transfer is because it's a strong plasma ejection from the Sun, and it's from deeper down in the Sun's corona than we would expect normal solar wind to come from. And this is what it is here. This is jets from the Sun, from normal solar wind further up in the Sun's corona. Now, this seems like a strong particle flux stream and is opposite of where this light is coming from. Also, it's interesting that this light is not just a bright patch. There are dark patches and regular patterns here, which would indicate the presence of ionized material, gaseous ionized material through which the light then streams through. And so this would indicate, again, a brown dwarf star, a stellar core being present here. And then we would have this particle flux transfer, which is to be expected between these objects and the Sun. Now, another object that we saw and I have written about extensively is the 2007 stellar core, which was observed in February of 2007. We see an image of it here. We see the stellar core, the envelope. At this time, it was emitting light from the envelope. One thing I have not talked about before is the surprising light seemingly come from the Sun, as if the surface of the Sun suddenly expanded outwards. And this, I think, is very interesting because the object in August so seems to elicit this kind of response from the Sun. Now, this object became darker as it approached the Sun, and we see that the object in the August images exhibits exactly the same behavior. It also becomes dimmer as it approaches the Sun. And then the object was bright initially, and then it became dimmer as it approached the Sun. And then suddenly it enters this area of possible particle flux transfer. It becomes brighter again, and brighter, and brighter, and brighter. Whilst at this point in time, the Sun seems to start reacting, the corona becomes much darker. So it reacts with darkness first. Then, after darkness, comes this outward expansion of plasma from the Sun, as if the surface of the Sun is expanding outwards. And then it could have been a CME, but there is no evidence that there was a CME that was Earth-directed on that day. And the Sun goes back to its normal shape and size soon after this, without any evidence of plasma separating from the normal surface of the sun, from the plasma that we see here, moving outwards into space. So it looks like an expansion of the surface of the sun. And this is a few minutes later, we see that the sun has gone back to its normal shape. There is no expansion of its surface to be seen anymore. However, the discontinuities and the straight lines seem to indicate that possibly something was being hidden at the time. We do see evidence of other stellar cores in the outer corona of the sun, these dark circular regions surrounded by the lighter cloud-like structures or the envelopes of these objects. These are, in fact, stellar cores, and we've been examining these for many months. And as you can see, there are quite a few here, and it indicates that in 2007 there were already quite a few of these objects surrounding the sun. Now, the reason why the sun interacts and has particle flux transfers as well as coronal holes is because the presence of these objects, which have very strong magnetic fields because they were once white dwarfs that lost the brightness of their emission to the point that they became dark, and now they still have a strong magnetic field, but they are not able to emit the same bright light. Their plasma is not as energetic as the sun's plasma. So when they approach the sun, their strong magnetic field pulls on the sun's magnetic field, so it can we can see through the magnetic field lines. They are basically drawn out towards the object. They form closed loops. So particles from the sun spiral along these field lines towards the object, and particles, ionized particles from this object, spiral along the returning field lines towards the sun. So there is this exchange of particles between the sun and a stellar core. And this means that the stellar core will become brighter and the sun will become darker. Now we are going to next look at the Core 1 images, which show the inner corona. Whilst the Core 2 images show the outer corona, and these show the inner corona. But we see exactly the same thing happening. First, this side of the sun, where the object is, becomes darker. Then it becomes brighter again. And then the side opposite to where the object was seen becomes dark, and that darkness seems to increase. This shows that the sun actually lost light emission during this time, and this is exactly the same time period we have seen in the Core 2 images. And if we look at the same time period in the EUVI images, it actually shows that the sun moved. So we see it moving upwards here in relation to this first image, and then it moves up further and up some more, up some more, up some more, and then downwards. So, and in this image is actually out of focus, showing that it was in motion when this image was taken. So this shows that the sun not only lost light emission and its surface expanded, but it also jolted. So, in conclusion, stereo B images, in particular Core 2, Core 1, and EUVI at 30.4 nanometer wavelength, show clear evidence that the bright object we are led to believe is Venus is not Venus, and it has a dramatic effect on the sun. The object appears to therefore be a stellar core, and this stellar core elicits a strong reaction from the sun, causing its surface to expand outwards. It causes it to lose light emission, and it causes it to jolt. So now we have an object that we can associate with the sun jolting. And this is extremely interesting, and it's also interesting that it happened when this object entered the particle flux stream between it and another object that appears to be just outside the image. This is Dr. Claudia Albers, Planet X physicist. Thank you for watching.